I find myself in a little bit of an awkward position this evening. Because usually I make notes, as we all do, and I use the notes as a guide to what to say. And just before the meeting started, somebody from USC said, Bob, would you please be sure to mention such and such at the end of your remarks? And I forgot to write it down. So I thought I would make the comments before I make my remarks. And the issue was the flowers on the table. And the comment I was asked to make was that if you look in the fly leaf, you'll notice that the centerpiece goes to the person whose birthday is close to Earth Day. Very small print. And the observation was made, if you were here last year and you won the centerpiece, you should not be eligible for this year. Well, I'm not going to comment on that. Let each table decide for themselves. But the main part of the announcement is that the silver bowl the flowers are in are not part of the table. And I've also have been advised that the wait staff has been asked to watch the door on your way out. So with that, here we are. This is the 31st award ceremony for the Talent Prize. And I always like to start by a big welcome and round of applause to the 2004 laureates. Bunker Roy, fashionable with the environment long before the environment was fashionable as it is now. And they established the trust that allows us to do this. The trust agreement establishes the executive committee. Well, what do we really do? We do three things.
we look after the resources of the trust and be sure that everything is preserved for a long time. We concern ourselves on a continuing basis with the international reputation and prestige of the Tyler Prize. That's very, very important to us. But perhaps the most difficult thing we do is we sit several times a year, I'm happy to report it's in this beautiful hotel, and we review nominations from around the world on a continuing basis. And on any given day, we have 100 nomination folders, many of which have been screened and screened 5, 6, 8, 10 times. And a challenge, of course, is how do you pick the best for that year at that time? And this year, we're particularly delighted with you gentlemen. We have the best of the best. A special pleasure for me is always to introduce the executive committee. And let me start with Dr. Joel Cohn, who's the Abby Rockamoss Professor at the University at Rockefeller University in New York, and the 1999 Tyler Laureate. And where is Joel? He's one of us. And sadly, I report that this weekend is the last time Joe will be with us as a member of the executive committee, but we're counting on him being with us on a continuing basis as a friend of the prize. And Joe, you know we're going to hold you to that. Okay. Dr. Bob Frosch is a senior fellow in the John F. Kennedy School of Government at Harvard University. Dr. Arturo Gomez-Pampas is a university professor at the University of California, Riverside, and a 1994 Tyler Prize laureate. Dr. Owen Lind is a charter member of the executive committee. That means he's been on the committee since it was first established, and he's a professor of biology at Baylor University. Dr. Jim Maloney is the Lewis Beaumont Professor of Surgery Emeritus from UCLA. Dr. Judy McDowell is a senior scientist at Woods Hole Oceanography Institute. Professor Ralph Mitchell is also a charter member of the executive committee, and he's the Gordon McKay Professor of Applied Biology at Harvard. Dr. Sherry Rowland is not only the 1983 Tyler Laureate, but he's also the 1995 Nobel Laureate in Chemistry, and currently the Donald Brent Professor of Chemistry at the University of Irvine. And Dr. Cornelius Sullivan is a Vice Provost for Research at the University of Southern California and our newest member to the committee. Around the time that the Tyler Prize was established, Alice Tyler also established what is known as the Tyler Perpetual Trust, which is a separate organization from the Tyler Prize. But they do wonderful things also for wonderful people. And we're always pleased to welcome the members of that trust here each year. We have Martha Pello. Martha, you here? Yeah, there you are. Alan Brown. I saw Alan. I know he's here. Anders Brown. You back there, Anders? Okay. Why do they always seat you so far back in the room? I'll check on that for next year. And Courtney Brown. Thanks for being here, Courtney. J. John Hogue. And Paul Lippert. The administration of the prize doesn't happen automatically. We have a wonderful partner in the University of Southern California who supports us in a wonderful fashion. We couldn't do it without them. And so I'd like to introduce our partner in the form of Dr. Donald Monahan, who's the Dean for Research of the College of Letters, Arts, and Sciences at USC. Please, does anybody have wine poured? Do they? Oh, okay. So it's going to be a while, so enjoy the wine.
Thank you very much, Bob. And it is indeed my pleasure, on behalf of the University of Southern California and the USC College of Letters, Arts, and Sciences Dean's Office, of which I am the Dean of Research, to welcome you here this evening. This is really, I've said this before, I know to some who've been here before, but of the, all of the things I do in my job as Dean, this is my number one joy, to come to this event this evening. I started out 20 years ago at USC as an assistant professor, and they put me back in one of the back tables back there. And one day I'll go back. But my job today, though, is to welcome, obviously, the Tyler laureates, as Bob has so well done, but also to welcome so many colleagues who are here, from professors at USC, professors at the University of California, Irvine, professors at University of California, Los Angeles, and UC Riverside. I won't go name you all, please, in the interest of time, but thank you so much for coming for this remarkable occasion. There's many reasons, many, many reasons, I think, for us to think how important this event here this evening. Certainly at a time of global conflict, global justice, global injustice, global economic pressures, I think it is fair to say it is easy to have the environment slip off many of the academic and political agendas. And what a mistake that would be. One of the powerful things about this evening is to help everybody remember how important environmental stability is. From the highest level of laureates, like the Tyler laureates, right down to our students and the next generation. Just a few hours ago, I was teaching a class, and there was 125 students in this class, and I was talking about the environment with my professorial hat on. And the students at the end of my little song and dance lecture started to ask me profound questions about the ozone hole, what is its status this year, about global warming, about biodiversity and conservation. Now, what was really profoundly touching to me about these students is that they were all 11 years old. These were sixth graders. Now, when I was in sixth grade, folks, if I could, find the bathroom, I would be impressed. So what is happening is that this environmental theme, and I think the Tyler Prize has played a huge role in this, keeps the environment active at all levels, through academia, through policy, through government, and right down into K-12, which is what my experience was this afternoon. And for all of the people who've worked for over 30 years at the university, at the Tyler laureates, all of the Tyler committees who've helped to keep this agenda going at some difficult times, no more difficult than this year, I really applaud you. And if I may please ask for a toast on behalf of the laureates, if everybody could please grab a glass to toast the 2004 Tyler laureates. Ladies and gentlemen, please raise your glasses.